Zealand's troops landed on the far of Gallipoli, and it was then, and in the violent campaign that followed, that the Anzac tradition was formed. The elements of that tradition have inspired and offered an enduring example to later generations of Australians.
Each year, we pay our respect not only to those original Anzacs, but to all who died or were disabled in their service to this country. They enrich our nation's history. Their hope was for the freedom of mankind, and we remember with pride their courage, their compassion, and their comradeship. They served on land and sea and in the air in many places throughout the world.
Not only do we honour the memory of those Australians who have fallen in battle, we share the sorrow of those who have mourned them and of all those who have been victims of armed conflict. On Anzac Day, we remember with sympathy and those Australians who have suffered as prisoners of war and those who, because of war, have had their lives shortened or handicapped.
Not only do we honour the memory of those Australians who have fallen in battle, we share the sorrow of those who have mourned them. What does Anzac mean? The word Anzac refers to the soldiers in the Australian and New Zealand Army Corps. Lieutenant General Sir William Burwood had to select a telegraphic code for his soldiers, and he did so by using the first letters of where the soldiers came from. These days, the dream of Anzac stands for comradeship, courage, and sacrifice, others before self. It also includes the laughter and the pride and the love of life that is in every Australian.
When is Anzac Day? On April 25th, we have a public holiday to commemorate the day the Anzacs landed at Gallipoli. The landing took place at dawn. That is why we have the Anzac Day services. That is why we have the dawn Anzac Day services. Each soldier carried a blanket, a waterproof sheet, a rifle with about 200 cartridges, some biscuits, meat, a bottle of water, and a few other things. He also had a kind of pickaxe or shovel for digging trenches. When night time came, everybody worked hard with these tools to make the trenches they needed for shelter from the doors. These trenches were the home for many soldiers for many months. During that time, thousands of soldiers were killed or wounded.
Why have we placed our war memorials? The war memorials have the name of soldiers from the area or town who have died engraved on them. Laurel wreaths worn around their head have been associated with heroes. Flowers have always been laid at funerals to show that we care. The wreaths made of laurel leaves and flowers are then our way of paying tribute to those heroic soldiers.
Why do we wear sprigs of rosemary? Rosemary is a compact green shrub that is grown in the area around where the soldiers landed in Gallipoli. In ancient times, rosemary was also supposed to strengthen memory. On Anzac Day, the wearing of small sprigs of rosemary in the coat lapel, pinned to the breast, or held in place by medals is therefore for both remembrance and commemoration.
Famous Anzac story. Private John Smithson, Simpson Kirkpatrick, the first British ambulance, aged 23, became a legend at Anzac. He didn't use his real name, it was Simpson. This is the story of Simpson and his donkey. Simpson decided soon after landing that the donkey would be useful to move the soldiers wounded in the leg. A number were landed at the soldiers' ends in carrying water. And each day, in half the night, Simpson brought casualties down with ashtray. Simpson escaped death many times.
However, while he was helping Donkey Duckley survived the campaign. The Glickley Memorial, near the Melbourne Shrine, is a bronze statue of an Australian soldier leading a donkey carrying a wounded man. It commemorates the courage and compassion associated with the brave exploits of the service at the Glickley. The memorial was erected in 1936.
Ode of Remembrance. They shall grow, not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not wear again, nor the years condemn. At the going down the sun and in the morning, we will remember them.
The Last Post. Next we'll review the music of The Last Post. It is a bugle call to signal the end of the day's fighting. Following the last post, we will have a minute silence. It is a mark of respect for the soldiers. During this time, please stand still and bow your heads.
Then we will hear some of the reveille. It is too long to play it all, but reveille breaks the silence that follows the playing of the last post. Reveille means wakey day, and was played to wake the troops up to start the day. On Anzac Day, it symbolises the awakening of the dead next to the war. Following reveille, Mrs. Gillette will lead us in the national anthem.